Okay, I have taken only one class on definite integral or two. Can anybody say, Nisha?
Yes,
Have I taken only one class or two class on definite integral?
so one class.
Only one class, na?
Yes,
Okay. Okay, I hope everybody can see the screen.
Yes,
yes, sir.
Let everyone enter, then I should start. Then every time I will be hampered. Well, so let us start. So this is the continuation of our previous class on definite integral. So we learned in the previous class how an integration a to b fx dx can be interpreted as a sum of some area of rectangular strip. Okay, so limit of a sum of some area, limit of h sum of a plus rh, where r is can be from 1 to n or 0 to n minus 1, whatever it is, depending on the left hand or right hand side convention, and For this, we will take NH is equal to B minus A, that is equal to 1, because we can always take A equal to 0 and B equal to 1. In that case, R will be equal to 1 to N. But if from the series I'm getting, in the series, I get that R is going from, suppose 1 to 4N, then we cannot take that 0 to 1, that will be 0 to alpha. And the alpha should be 4. Okay, alpha should be 4. So these things we have already discussed in the last class. So today we will just again continue our discussion on that and solve some more problems on that. So substitution in a definite integral. So you already know how to what is the purpose of substitute? What is the purpose of substitution? Actually, definite integral or indefinite integral, whatever it is, integrating something is an indirect process. First of all, we have to think which function on differentiation will produce the given function, integrand. Which the differentiation of which function is the integrand. Then the integral of this function, integrand, will be that function. Suppose I have given integration of x squared dx. So we should first think that what is the differentiation, what is the function whose differentiation is x squared. So we can take one part of x cube. Now follow?
Sir, some are waiting, sir.
Some are waiting. 66. So if we are given integration of x squared dx, suppose. So we have to think first that which is the function whose differentiation is x squared. So this is very simple. We can just in a small thinking, we can find out this is the 1/3 x cube. But whatever be the situation, this is an indirect process. That is why integration is always more difficult than differentiation. So our general technique will be to, given any function, we have to change it to a standard integral, standard form, whose differentiation we know. That means we have already calculated some definite integrals. Definite integrals with standard forms and whose integrations are known to us. Okay, for example, integration of root over of a square plus x square, integration of 1 by root over of x square, all these integrations are done. So what we do, we by the method of substitution, we try to convert our given integral into some standard form whose integration we know. This is the sole purpose of substitution. Okay. Now, here they are telling that while integrating the corresponding integral between limits, that means for suppose integration of on x, limit on x a to b, we can avoid the tedious process of restoring the original variable by changing the limits of the definite integral to correspond with the change in the variable. That means they are saying that if the integration is given in terms of x, suppose integration of x squared dx a to b, now if you substitute x squared is equal to t, then you will get the integration in terms of t, then all after all process you will get a function in t. Then again sometime it is not very easy to convert this t to x, then derive the entire function in terms of the original variable x. Okay, and then only we can put the original variable limit a to b. Okay, fb minus fa. That sometime it is simpler, it is more easy to keep it in the t form, in the converted form, and to change the variable values, the upper and lower range values in terms of t, the upper and lower range values in terms of t. Okay, then we don't have to again restore the function in terms of t again. So these are the substitutions should be effected in three places: in the integrand, in the differential, that is dx should be always changed to dt or du, whatever you take, and in the limits a to b, that may be changed to some p to q, depending on the nature of substitution. Okay, let us take one example. 0 to 1, sin inverse x. Someone is waiting. Okay, so 0 to 1, sin inverse x by root over 1 minus x square dx. All of you know this integral. It's very simple. But the example that if you want to integrate this thing directly, it will be very difficult. It is not very easy. So in order to change it in the standard form, we have to make some substitution. Okay. We have to make some substitution. So what substitution we effect here? Sin inverse x equal to theta. Sin inverse x equal to theta. Okay. Then this d theta will be equal to 1 by root over 1 minus x square dx. Can anybody say where from this is coming? Where from this is coming? Can anybody say this expression? If I don't like to memorize this result, how we can deduce this result? D theta is equal to dx by root over 1 minus x square. Can anybody say where from this can be found? Actually, I will always try to memorize this.
Differentiation of sine theta.
I got it. But sine inverse x differentiation will be, you have to remember, 1 by root over 1 minus x square. If I don't remember it, then can't we do it? Suppose you have forgot, what is the differentiation of sine inverse, cot inverse, cos inverse, then? See, it is very simple. From this, we have x is equal to sine theta. X is equal to sine theta, not differentiate both sides. dx is equal to cos theta d theta. dx is equal to cos theta d theta. And what is cos theta? Root over of cos square theta. That is root over of 1 minus sine square theta. And what is sine theta? X. So root over of 1 minus x square. Okay. Then dx will be equal to, d theta will be equal to 1 by root over of 1 minus x square dx. So without remembering anything, we can find it from the differentiation of only sine theta cos theta, you have to remember. Okay. So now what they are saying that change the upper and lower limits in terms of theta. Okay. So that you don't have to again restore the function in terms of x again when you are done. So first of all, let us see what is happening. Sine inverse x is equal to theta, so it should be theta, and 1 by this entire root over 1 square dx is d theta. So it will be theta d theta. Okay. This one, theta d theta. Now, in theta d theta, what is the upper limit, lower limit change? See. So sine inverse x is equal to theta. So sine inverse 0 is 0 because sine 0 is 0. Okay. So sine inverse 0 is 0. And sine inverse 1 is pi by 2. Sine inverse 1 is pi by 2. Okay. This one, pi by 2. So the upper and lower limit will change to 0 to pi by 2, simple. So you are just getting very simple thing, theta d theta 0 to pi by 2. That will be half theta square 0 to pi by 2, that is pi square by 8. Okay. So we don't have to again write this theta in terms of sine inverse, all these things is not needed. Sometime maybe it is not very easy, difficult in this case, but maybe it is difficult for some other case. So always it is wiser to change the upper and lower limit in terms of the new variable. That is what they are saying. This one, the effect, though we can avoid tedious process of restoring the original variable by changing the limits of the definite integral to correspond with the change of the variable. Okay. So the limit should be changed. Now I hope everybody could understand this thing, this problem.
Yes,
very
sir.
Simple problem.
Yes, sir. Okay.
The next problem. This problem. Evaluate alpha to beta square root of x minus alpha into beta minus x dx. Here also we make a substitution because this form root over of this. It's not very easy. This is not a standard form. We have to convert it into a standard form so that we can write down the integration result. So here we are putting x is equal to alpha cos square theta plus beta sin square theta. So please remember that dx will be equal to then 2 alpha cos theta sin theta, then 2 beta sin theta cos theta. And cos theta into differentiation of cos theta is minus sin theta. So this will be minus. So 2 alpha cos theta minus sin theta. That means 2 sin theta cos theta minus. So this will be there, and this will be 2 beta sin theta cos theta. This will be plus. So if you take 2 sin theta cos theta common, this will be beta minus alpha. Beta minus alpha. Okay, this will be minus. There will be one minus sign because differentiation of cos theta is minus. So you get dx is equal to twice beta minus alpha sin theta cos theta d theta. Okay. And this x minus alpha, this thing will be, okay, x minus alpha is this alpha cos square theta plus beta sin square theta minus alpha. So if you take minus alpha common, that will be 1 minus cos square theta. If you take minus alpha common, so it will be beta sin square theta plus minus alpha sin square theta. That is beta minus alpha sin square theta. Okay. Similarly, beta minus x, that will be beta minus alpha cos square theta. Beta minus alpha cos square theta. So their product will give you beta minus alpha square sin square theta cos square theta. And square root of this thing will give you beta minus alpha into sin theta cos theta. So beta minus alpha sin theta cos theta, this is the integral. Hello? Anybody is asking anything?
Please repeat.
This, it was just follow this substitution. X minus alpha. What is x minus alpha? Alpha cos square theta plus beta sin square theta minus alpha. That means if you take alpha cos square theta minus 1, that is minus sin square theta. Okay? So beta minus alpha sin square theta. Are you clear on that?
Okay, sir.
Similarly, beta minus x will be beta minus alpha cos square theta. You just calculate it, it will know. It will be clear. Now, dx is 2 beta minus alpha sin theta cos theta. And this square root of this integrand will be again beta minus alpha into sin theta cos theta. So that means beta minus alpha whole square, that will come outside here. Beta minus alpha whole square, 2 will come outside, and sin square theta cos square theta, pi by 2.
So some students are waiting.
Still some students are waiting. Amit.
Yes, sir.
Please try to be in time. It is already 12:17:20. In the entire class, if you go on entering them.
I was there at 12:02. But due to network, I got out from the class.
You left it.
Due to network problem, sir.
And Nikunj? What? Network problem. Where from you are connecting? From Asansol or outside Asansol?
Outside Asansol.
Where?
From Bihar.
Bihar. Oh. And Nikunj, what happened to you, Nikunj? Nikunj Ranjan? Okay. So this will be beta minus alpha square twice sin square theta cos square theta. One sin theta cos theta is coming from this d theta from dx. From dx is equal to twice beta minus alpha sin theta cos theta. And from this integrand, another is coming beta minus alpha sin theta cos theta. So it will be beta minus alpha square sin theta cos theta. Okay. Then now sin square theta cos square theta, this can be written as 1/4 sin square theta cos square theta. That is sin 2 theta whole square, because sin 2 theta is 2 sin theta cos theta. And sin square 2 theta, this can be written as 1 minus cos 4 theta. You should be remembering all this chapter of multiple and submultiple angle in trigonometry, basic 11-12 chapter. Cos 2 theta is 1 minus 2 sin square theta. So cos 4 theta will be 1 minus 2 sin square 2 theta. From that, sin square 2 theta will be 1 minus cos 4 theta. So the integral will be twice of beta minus alpha whole square into 1 by 8, 1 minus cos 4 theta. 1 by 8 will be coming outside, and 1 minus cos 4 theta, that will be theta minus 1 4th sin 4 theta. And if you integrate from 0 to pi by 2, because, okay, from 0 to pi by 2, I'm getting from this, see, from this substitution, x is equal to alpha cos square theta plus beta sin square theta. If you put x is equal to alpha, then what will happen? Alpha into sin square theta is equal to beta sin square theta. So alpha cannot be equal to beta. So only sin theta equal to 0. So theta is equal to 0. Again, if you put x is equal to beta, then beta cos square theta is equal to alpha cos square theta. So cos square theta will be same. That means cos square theta must be 0. So theta is equal to pi by 2. Okay, from this you are getting 0 to pi by 2. Are you clear on that? Anybody is confused? How we are getting 0 to pi by 2 result? Everyone is clear? Having any question? Again, I am telling. Suppose I have to assume that alpha not equal to beta. If alpha equal to beta, then there is no meaning of integrating this thing. That will be simply equal to 0. Because upper and lower end same means there is a point, only all 0. So alpha not equal to beta. If alpha not equal to beta, and if you put here x equal to alpha, so alpha sin square theta, alpha minus alpha cos square theta, alpha sin square theta is equal to beta. So alpha not equal to beta, so only possibility is sin square theta must be equal to 0. From that, theta is equal to 0. And if you put x equal to beta, then beta minus beta sin square theta, that is beta cos square theta is equal to alpha cos square theta. Again, cos square theta should be equal to 0. From that, theta is equal to pi by 2. So the result, range will be 0 to pi by 2. So 0 to pi by 2, theta minus 1 by 4 sin 4 theta, that will give you only pi by 2, because sin of 4 into pi by 2 is 2 pi, sin of 2 pi is 0, sin 0 is 0, and theta is also at 0 equal to 0. So only pi by 2. That means pi by 8 beta minus alpha square. Pi by 8 beta minus alpha whole square. This is the result of the integral. I hope everyone is clear on that.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, now, next question. When this type of summation will be given, so this is actually the application of the definite integral. We know that the theory, we know integral a to b fx dx can be just equivalent to limit of h sum of a plus rh, r is equal to either 0 to n minus 1 or 1 to n, where limit h tending to 0 is taken. Okay, now without any loss of generality, you can take a is equal to 0, then b equal to 1, then f of a plus rh, that will be simply f of rh, and the integration will be from 0 to 1. Nh is equal to b minus a, that is 1. Keeping this in mind, now we try to convert this series into some equivalent definite integral. So what we do, we first write down the rth term. So it is 1 by n plus 1, 1 by n plus 2, 1 by n plus 3, up to n by n plus n. So what is the rth term? 1 by n plus r. 1 by n plus r. Now, divide both sides with 1 by n. So that will give you 1 by n by this one. 1 by n by 1 plus r by n. Okay? 1 by n by 1 plus r by n. And this 1 by n you take outside, common. What is 1 by n? All of you know. What is 1 by n? That is equal to h, because nh is equal to 1 here. So we are getting h into summation of 1 plus rh, because this 1 by n is also h, 1 plus rh. So this is your frh. What is frh? 1 by 1 plus rh. So what is fx? 1 by 1 plus x. That means we are getting the integral 0 to 1, 1 by 1 plus x dx. that is log of 1 plus x 0 to 1, that is log 2. Again, go through the steps carefully. I am first identifying the rth term, then I am dividing r with n. I am getting 1 by n common outside and writing this as h, 1 by n as h. So in the within the sum also we are writing r by n as rh, so 1 by 1 plus rh. So this will be our frh according to the theory, h summation of frh. When I have taken a equal to 0, b equal to 1, this will be f of rh. So that means fx is equal to 1 by 1 plus x 0 to 1, that is equal to log 2. Is everybody clear?
Yes, sir.
Anyone else?
So once more explain the last step.
Key explain konta bujhe jani bolo last line
sir ei je amra h ta nilam 1 by n otodur to thik ache kintu last line ta bujhte paralam na oi je
kano a 1 by 1 summation er moddhe ki likhecho 1 by 1 plus rh thik ache to r equal to 1 to n because here I you see here where from r is starting 1 1 2 3 4 up to n, so 1 to n, so this expression will be f of rh. Tell what is that? F of rh is equal to 1 by 1 plus rh. Remember it, f of rh is equal to 1 by 1 plus rh. So what is fx?
1 by 1.
What is fx? 1 by 1 plus x. Have written this thing?
Yes, sir.
So I can write down the integral as 0 to 1, 1 by 1 plus x dx. Now we will use the process of integration, usual process of integration. Okay. This is the reverse way. This is the reverse way. In the theory, we proved that this integral is equivalent to this sum. Now here we are constructing the sum. Then from the sum, we are reverse engineering by in the proceeding in the earlier path, the reverse path, we are finding the integral and then we are integrating. Okay, suppose this is another So next problem is 1 by 1 plus n square whole to the power 2 by n square into 1 by 2 square by n square whole to the power 4 by n square this way. 2, 4, 6, so try to follow the pattern carefully. Try to follow the pattern. And the first one you take as 1 square. It will be clear then. 1 square, 2 square, 3 square. And that is 2, 4, 6 up to 2n. So what will be the common term? What is the rth term? It will be simply 1 by r square by n square, isn't it? 1 by r square by n square, then 2n, 2r by n square, 2r by n square, okay? R is going from 2 into 1, 2 into 2, 2 into 3, 2 into 4, 2 into n. So 2 into r, so 2r by n square. So 1 plus r square by n square into 2r by n square. Now, suppose this original expression is equal to a. It is not in the summation form. Okay, so we cannot apply our theorem. So we have to express this product form, convert this product term into summation form, isn't it? Now in order to do that, we will take help of logarithm because we know that
sir,
log of bolo.
Sir, nothing is visible. Kuch bhi nahi dekh rahi hai.
कुछ भी नहीं देख रहा है
hmm.
क्यों anybody can cannot see anything
it is visible sir
visible sir yes visible
so maybe it is your problem who is talking cannot see
sir Jovita
চইটা তুমি দেখতে পাচ্ছ মোবাইলে দেখছো
ইয়েস স্যার
মোবাইলে মাঝে মাঝে গন্ডগোল হয় তুমি আবার ফ্রেশ ফ্রেশ করে আবার নতুন করে কই করো ফ্রেশ করে ঢোকো আবার
ওকে স্যার ওকে
ফ্রেশ করে ঢোকো সো লগ অফ এবি ইজ इक्वल टू লগ এ প্লাস লগ বি ইন জেনারেল লগ অফ এ বি সি ডি इक्वल टू লগ এ প্লাস লগ বি প্লাস লগ সি সো লগ ডি দিস প্রপার্টি অল অফ ইউ নো দিস ইজ দ্য ইনভেন্টরি ম্যাটেরিয়াল সো আই উইল ইউজ দ্যাট সো আই উইল টেক এ ইজ इक्वल टू দিস এন্টার প্রোডাক্ট So log A will be equal to log of this, that is log of first term plus log of second term. So I can write and log of x to the power 5, you know that log of x to the power 5 is 5 log x. Any power within the log comes down to the left hand side of the log. Log of x to the power 5 is 5 log x. Log of 3 to the power 2 is 2 log 3. So log of this 1 plus r square by n square to the power 2r by n square, that will be 2r by n square log of 1 plus r square by n square. Up to this is clear to all. Log A is equal to sum of this 2r by n square log of 1 plus r square by n square. Is it clear to all?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. There should not be any problem. This is a simple logarithm is taken and summation is taken. Now, what is the next step? Tell me 1 by n take common. So 1 by n take common and 2 also common. 2 is a constant will come out and 1 by n take common. So it will be r by n so r by n log 1 plus r square by n square so we can take this r by n as rh and log of 1 plus rh r square h square okay so the function will be what is that f of rh what is tell me what is f of rh look at carefully this 2 and 1 by n have taken outside 2 and 1 by n so we are left with within summation we are left with r by n log of 1 plus r square by n square now r by n is h rh and r square by n square will be r square h square so it will be rh log 1 plus rh so what is the function x log 1 plus x so our integration will be 0 to 1 2 was there constant to x log 1 plus x Now simple substitution again 1 plus x square is equal to z so 2x will be equal to z and that will give you log z dz and at x is equal to 0 z equal to 1 x is equal to 1 z equal to 2 so this will be simple z log z minus z by parts 1 to 2 2 log 2 minus 1 that is log log 4 by e because okay one can be written as log e to the base e log e to the base e and 2 log 2 as I told you this is basically log 4 so log 4 minus log e that is log of 4 by e are everybody is clear on the last line is clear to all
yes sir
one
yes,
can sir. Be written as log e to the base e and log 2 log 2 is basically log 4 so log 4 minus log e that is log 4 by e so this is the value of not a this is the value of log a remember I have already taken the log of a that means log of a in the limit in n tends to infinity or a tends to 0 whatever it is that will be log 4 by e so a will be equal to what is a
4 by e
Only 4 by e, simple. So this is the actual result. 4 by e. Okay. Next. Next. Take another problem 1 to the power m plus 2 to the power m up to n to the power m by n to the power m plus 1 this should be shown to be 1 by m plus 1 this is also very simple because the rth term is r to the power m by r to the power m plus n now if you take n 1 by n common that will be r by n whole to the power m so This entire thing can be written as limit of 1 by n sum of r by n whole to the power m r equal to 1 to n, because this is going from 1 to n. So obviously you can write it will be r h whole to the power m, so function x to the power m, so it will be x to the power m dx 0 to 1, that is 1 by 1 m plus 1. I don't think this problem can be difficult for anyone. Very simple problem. Everybody got it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So yes, next, sir, we will discuss something which is interesting and which is not found in many books. That the first results, result A. Look at the result A carefully. This is we already have discussed. So limit of n tends to infinity or h tends to zero, whatever. In same thing, summation of 1 by n r f of r by n r is equal to 1 to n or 0 to n minus 1. This is equal to 0 to 1 fx dx. That we know. Now, if this r is not ending at n but going to twice n or thrice n, whatever it is, then if r is in general going to pn, 1 to pn, say, 1 to pn, look carefully, 1 to pn sum of 1 by n r by n, so that should be equal to f of x dx alpha to beta, where alpha is equal to limit of r by n as r equal to 1, n tends to infinity, that is 0, and beta will be equal to r by n, that is pn by n, that is pn by n, n tends to infinity, that will be equal to p when e r equal to pn. So in general, if r equal to n, that will be 1. So this is a general case. This case is a general case. When p equal to 1, then this integration will be 0 to 1. If p is equal to, if that is p is equal to not 1, that is r equal to pn, where p not equal to 1, then this upper limit will be p, 0 to p. Okay, lower limit will not change, but upper limit will be p. Keep this in mind. Result B is important. Keep it in mind, because any many problem is there where this thing will be useful. Okay, everybody is clear to that? Result 2, result B?
Yes, sir.
Now take this problem. Limit 1 by twice n plus 1 by twice n plus 1 up to 1 by 6 n, that is equal to, there are 3-4 options, but I'm not going for options, that will be equal to, shown to be log 3. Now here, if you see that r is going from 2n plus 0, then 2n plus 1, then 2n plus 2, up to which r is going, tell me. 2n plus
n.
Look at this pattern. 2n plus 0, 2n plus 1, 2n plus 2. So which will make it 6n?
So 3 into
4n. 2n plus 4n.
Oh, you are not following the pattern. Who is saying 3 into 2n? The way the series is coming, follow how the series is coming. Always you should observe the pattern. 2n, 2n plus 1, that is 2n plus 0 plus 2n plus 1. So up to 2n plus 4n, that will make it 6n. So what is the rth term? 2n plus r. 2n plus r. Okay, so we will get, let me, so what is the thing? I hope everybody can see the screen. So the result will be 0 to 4. And what is that? 1 by, okay, let me write once again, then I will convert it into this thing. 1 by 2n plus r. That means if you take 1 by n common, Okay, let it be written as summation. I don't want to write this way, that will be confusing. Let it be noted by summation. So, summation R is equal to 0 to 0 to 4n, and that will be 1 by 2n plus 4n, 2n plus r. This is the thing, everybody is clear? Everybody is clear?
Yes, sir.
0 to 4n, 1 by 2n plus r. If you take 1 by n common, then what will happen? Tell me. If you take 1 by n common, it will be 2 plus r by n, isn't it? Think. One by n means you are adjusting here with n. You have taken one by n common. It will be adjusting the n. So divide both numerator denominator with n. That will be one by 2n plus r by n.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So that you can also write that is as, okay, this is the, ultimately there is a limit. Limit. Limit there will be h tending to 0. H tending to 0. The same thing will be here also. Limit h tending to 0, and this thing will be changed to. Okay, let me write once again. Okay, h equal to h tends to 0, this should be simply h, because 1 by n is h, and this should be only rh. Now you should be equal to tell, you should be in a position to tell us. Tell me, what will be the equivalent integration? What is the equivalent integration? Tell me.
So 1 by 2 plus x.
Okay, this thing I'm fixing 1 by 2 plus x. Very good. And limit will be dx. A limit will be
zero to.
That is the theory. Again, I'm going to the theory. What is that? Tell me. Look at the result B carefully, everyone, and tell me.
Zero to four.
Because P is four here. Pn is four. So it should be 0 to 4. That is, what is that? Log of
2 plus x.
You can do it, okay? That I need not do it. Then it should be, it will be from 0 to 4. Okay.
So that is equal to
log 3.
0 to 4. Sorry, 0 to 4. So 2 log 6 minus log 2. What is that? Log 6 minus log 2. That is equal to log 3. Okay? Everyone is clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So this is the result. So the first one, actually natural log is often given by log n, ln, natural log. E to the base, base is E. So this is ln 3. In the second problem also, R is going from 1 to n. There is no problem. R is going from 1 to n. Okay. So I'm not doing the second and third problem. I am keeping this thing as an exercise and you will solve it. Okay. Okay, this thing I will discuss next class. Today, I don't want to proceed anymore. Okay, so just. Now tell me, everyone, anyone is having any question, anything?
No, sir.
Okay. So the material is understood to all. So I am just giving you the note immediately. And the problems, you solve some problems from the note also. So, and give your attendance. Give your attendance.
Sir, in our syllabus, indefinite integral is not there, sir.
No. Wait, you don't hear me. Only definite integral and these things. Properties of definite integral. Now, next we will start properties of definite integral. Priyobroto, why are you giving in WhatsApp group? What I'm telling you? Open the Google form and do it. Again, you are giving all in your WhatsApp group. Nisha, why are you doing these things? These will not be recorded. I'm telling everyone, open the Google form and give it. I have given you two or three times, I have said it. Everyone, open the Google form and do it. Why are you doing this all wrong things? Every day I'm telling you, open the Google form and give your attendance, okay? I've already given the link. Okay, I'm stopping. Bye, everyone.
Thank you.
Okay. Thank everyone, you, open the Google form and then take. Why you are doing attendance in our group? Okay.